Yes, sir, we promised you a great
gorgeous George. Here it comes.
Ready, Blassie, the maker of
Andre, the giant.
WrestleMania.
Everyone has a price.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is electric.
You are fired.
The champ is here.
WWE Superstars. I'm Scott Stanford alongside Josh Matthews as Alex Riley gets set for action one-on-one here on Superstars. And Josh, Hell in a Cell, sheer chaos, my friend.
Oh, we're going to get into all of it right here tonight on Superstars.
The entire WWE Universe, their mouths still wide open. Bring it a little bling to the ring. Here comes JTG and Josh. I love when we get JTG out here. It gives you and I a chance to dig down deep for our inner gangster. A chance for us to be chilling like villains, my friend.
You and I combined have zero inner gangster. But nonetheless, JTG has enough for everyone with the custom bling, the custom sunglasses, not to mention the bedazzled belt of JTG.
He says he's the flyest superstar here in the WWE. And I'll tell you what, I think this match comes about because I know JTG's had a little problem with A-Rai's quick rise up the ladder here in the WWE. And JTG says he's been busting his butt ever since he was a kid in Brooklyn, and everything comes so easy for Riley. You feel like it's been an easy rise for Alex?
Absolutely not. I think Alex Riley has done everything that he can do to put himself in a great position here in WWE. A victory over JTG will keep Alex Riley trending in the right direction.
JTG starting out on the offensive, but here goes A-Rai.
This is what Alex Riley has unleashed over the past number of months here. Pure intensity from Alex Riley.
I said it last time, A-Rai, that rare breed. As here comes the A-bomb from A-Rai.
Alex Riley, 6'3", 236 pounds. In control right now, JTG.
He is that rare breed of size, strength, and athletic ability. Like you said, Josh, 6'3", 230. Guy moves around like he's a middleweight. JTG, nice counter there.
JTG, who considers himself an entrepreneur, would love to be in a power position here in WWE.
JTG, man, I'll tell you what, as he goes in for the pin there. JTG graduating from those mean streets in Brooklyn with a degree in flyology. I was always good in biology. Flyology, like you said, not too good.
What was JTG's minor?
I'm not really sure. Chemistry, I think. As he goes to work again here on Alex Riley. You shake your head in disgust. I see it.
Not so much disgust right there. Counter there by Alex Riley.
A-Rai, the elbow. Oh! Beautiful move by JTG going in for the cover. Hook of the leg. Can't pick up the win. JTG now going to work again.
Come on in, Riley. Come on, pretty boy.
You hear JTG shouting pretty boy to A-Rai. And I got to tell you, He won't admit it. I've seen A-Rod's Twitter account. Guy gets proposals on a daily basis from women all over the world. It's unbelievable.
Not hard to believe. Alex Riley graduated with a 4.0 GPA from Boston College. Told me earlier today that he got a 1600 on his SAT.
1600?
It's before they changed the scoring. Now it's a lot higher, but back then 1600 was the highest you can get.
Man, oh man. A-Rod's going to need to get some smart work here if he wants to pick up a win over JTG. As here we go, A-Rod turns it around now. Oh, there it is, the game changer from Alex Riley. I've seen your Twitter account too, my friend. Not too shabby.
Okay.
Couple proposals from some women for you.
See, Alex Riley now looking to take advantage of the space created moments ago.
There goes A-Rod. Alex Riley's got that look in his eye now. When he turns it on, he really turns it on. Man, vicious spine buster. A-Rod now can taste it.
Seething is Alex Riley.
Oh. Head first goes JTG. A-Rod, no. Wow. Thought it was over for JTG right there. Talking earlier about how Alex Riley's got the movements of a middleweight in the middle of that ring. So big and so strong, but he can really move around. Let's go. Oh, JTG now. JTG gonna pick up a big, no. Riley digging down deep, and JTG very frustrated. Two terrific athletes going at it here on WWE Superstars.
Very curious to see how JTG is going to follow up that great combination of moves here on Alex Riley.
Riley counters out of it. Look at that. Saw face first. He plants him right into the mat. Look at the leg. A-Rod. Wow. To be impressed with Alex Riley again, Josh.
Alex Riley, a superstar who breeds Rottweilers in his spare time, considers himself a rare superstar, but JTG was looking good early. Check this out right there. But Alex Riley was able to sidestep JTG, who took just a split second too long. Alex Riley would capitalize on the window of opportunity being slightly open, and Alex Riley walks away victorious, continuing to trend in the right direction.
Boy, you look up the term pure athlete, you'll see a picture of Jim Thorpe holding an 8x10 of Alex Riley.
Almost like a Lambo leap there for Riley.
Absolutely. Still to come here on Superstars. New Orleans was turned upside down this past Sunday as Hell in a Cell was nothing short of bedlam and pandemonium. We're going to take a look at the chaotic aftermath of that triple threat match for the WWE Championship. It is coming up next. Has Triple H lost control of the WWE? Both the locker room and the WWE Universe wondering after the COO attacked to handcuff Miz and R-Truth following their brutal assault on the participants of Sunday's triple threat match inside Hell in a Cell. Check out complete match results and exclusive photos from Hell in a Cell only on WWE.com. And ladies and gentlemen, we're going to take you back now to New Orleans and Hell in a Cell, where what followed that triple threat match was nothing short of chaos and bedlam.
Back into the cell. Cena back. Look at this. Who the hell
is going on here?
Who on earth?
Cena's being assaulted.
What the hell?
I think that's Miz and R-Truth. It's R-Truth and Miz.
And the referees are being assaulted.
R-Truth and Miz are assaulting Cena. And the referees, and there's no one obviously more official. And Triple H is the CEO. And the cell has been lowered back to the ground. The cell was lowered back to the ground.
Who lowered the cell back to the ground?
I have no idea. but it allowed Miz and R-Truth to get inside. They are assaulting Punk and Cena and the officials and Del Rio.
You gotta be kidding me. These guys are
and the cell's locked, guys. The cell's locked. The key's inside. There is no way to get the cell open.
This is anarchy.
Miz and R-Truth.
Oh, my goodness.
Come on.
Are assaulting these men. There's nothing anybody can do about it. The locker room's here.
Man, somebody needs to do something about this right here. This is ridiculous.
Open the can.
I think one of the cameramen was assaulted as well.
Somebody got to get in that cage.
There's only one way in.
Superstars are trying to somehow get inside the cell, but they can't do it. It's locked. And Miz and R-Truth are laying waste to everything.
My God, the carnage is overwhelming.
This is a mugging.
R-Truth and Miz don't work here anymore.
Okay, Miz and R-Truth have lost their damn mind. Oh, bro, you got to be kidding me. What the hell is going on here?
Oh, look at this. And R-Truth.
Oh, God. You. What the hell's wrong with both you guys?
R-Truth and Miz are attacking and assaulting everything in their path.
For the love of God, get the door open.
And now there's armed security. Police officers down here.
Unlock the damn door.
They can't. They can't get in.
Come on. We gotta get somebody out here.
Cut the lock. Cut the chain. Help these people.
And finally, look at this. Finally, some ball cutters.
My God, they got ball cutters.
Get that lock quick. Come on.
Get in there.
And now the
door.
Doors are open.
Get in there, David, help somebody.
And look at R-Truth. R-Truth and Miz. They're surrendering.
Well, this is not justice. It makes me sick.
R-Truth and Miz have voluntarily given up. They've been handcuffed. Being led out of the ring.
You gotta be kidding me. I mean, these guys got police out here. I mean, this is justice, of course, but we need street justice. That's what we need for Miz and R-Truth. They need the hell beat out of there right now, tonight.
But Miz and R-Truth are proud of what they've done. They are proud of being arrested. In their minds, they made some sort of statement tonight.
That's what I'm talking about.
There's
street
your
justice. That's street justice right there. That's the kind of justice I'm talking about. A beatdown, a good old-fashioned beatdown by Triple H.
Triple H
taking down Orton Artis. My God.
Triple H.
It's living.
The CEO of this company
has exploded.
I think Triple H is being arrested. And quite frankly, he should not be arrested.
What are you talking about?
That's enough.
Boy, I still can't believe it all came down to this. As still to come tonight, Triple H looking for a vote of confidence from the WWE roster this past Monday night on Raw. Superstars expressing their concerns over the current work environment. We'll hear what's on the minds of the superstars. We'll hear from Triple H. How this ends, my friends, will leave you speechless.
The following
here on WWE Superstars as Michael McGillicuddy gets set for one-on-one action. And Josh McGillicuddy told me today he's happy to finally showcase himself in singles action.
Yeah, Michael McGillicuddy, a former WWE Tag Team Champion. This is a very important match for Michael McGillicuddy to get started in the right direction in singles competition.
Mr. Showtime, Percy Watson. Josh, this kid's got enough energy and charisma, and he can light up an entire city.
Pop out of the screen personality does Percy Watson possess at 6'6", 245 pounds. Percy Watson, in my opinion, is going to be a player here in WWE.
Would you ever use that term to describe me if anyone ever asked you, pop out of the screen personality?
Nope.
Thank you. Just thought I'd ask. Thanks for coming tonight. Percy recently teaming up with Titus O'Neil in tag team action. You know, I like that combination. I think those two have a bright future here in the WWE. But right now it's singles competition. Percy, McGillicuddy, one-on-one here on Superstars.
Come on, you think you can handle me? You think you're my ring? I think you're my
And you know, you talk about Michael McGillicuddy having something to prove. In my conversation with him today, Josh, he mentioned that he's tired of people saying he'll never be his father, Hall of Famer Curt Hennig. And he said he's going to try his best to fill the Hall of Famer's shoes. He's going to do his best to live up to that reputation. You mentioned it earlier. He feels he's got a lot to prove.
Well, McGillicuddy off to a great start here against Percy Watson. Tremendous athleticism by both of these superstars.
I told you, get out of the corner. Come on,
Percy, of course, with that. Oh, wow. An NFL background. McGillicuddy also. Tremendous athlete in college. And both of them find themselves here in the WWE.
Yeah, both of them find themselves trying to navigate the treacherous waters of WWE.
McGillicuddy in now. Nothing.
I do like the attitude and aggression we're seeing from Michael McGillicuddy here.
Oh! Neck breaker. Hook of the leg. Percy in trouble. No. McGillicuddy, a former WWE Tag Team Champion with David Otunga. Otunga, of course, that Harvard Law degree right now coming in handy these days over on the Raw side.
And Michael McGillicuddy wasting no time, not giving any space or separation to Percy Watson. There you see a great look at the intensity in the eyes of McGillicuddy.
Now, from what I understand, these two had a little incident in a restaurant somewhere. Percy ran into McGillicuddy either this week or the week earlier. McGillicuddy had made some unflattering comments about Percy's friend Titus O'Neil. Well, a ruckus ensued. Percy and McGillicuddy were escorted out. And I think that's how we got here tonight, these two trying to settle a score of some sort.
See, you always have the inside scoop as to why these guys really just don't like each other.
You know, when I see these matches set up, I want to know why they're going after each other here on Superstars. It's got to be a reason. Wow. McGillicuddy running right into the big boot. And Zaguri to the side of the head. Man, oh man, two tremendous athletes in the middle of that ring.
It's an opportunity here for Percy Watson to kind of gather himself, get his wits about him. Michael McGillicuddy's been in control throughout much of this matchup.
Uppercuts now. Both fellas back and forth. Oh. Flying through the air goes Percy. Who could take advantage?
Percy Watson's taking advantage right now.
One, two, three. You gotta get out of there. Let's go, Watson.
Oh!
Get up, man. Oh, yeah.
Oh! Percy meets the feet of Michael McGillicuddy. Oh!
McGillicuddy turned Watson inside out.
That patented neck breaker. McGillicuddy victorious.
Here is your winner, Michael McGillicuddy.
You said said it, Josh. McGillicuddy looking to start here tonight. Look at the look on his face.
Well, Percy Watson here took just a little bit too much time trying to get in position. Michael McGillicuddy would take advantage. And then McGillicuddy, so quick right here, just bang. It's just enough of Percy Watson. And McGillicuddy picking up a very important victory as Michael McGillicuddy looks to, well, start anew here in WWE.
Well, later on tonight, as promised, we will show you what went down at Raw last Monday. Superstars, divas, referees, even announcers and cameramen, they all walked out on the COO. It was indeed a surreal night at the conclusion of Raw.
Black Bell Brides for Set the World on Fire, the official Hell in a Cell theme. It's off the album Set the World on Fire, available now on iTunes.
The following is a Divas match scheduled for one fall. Introducing first from the Pacific Islands, Tom.
Welcome, everybody, to the SmackDown portion of WWE Superstars. I'm Jack Corpello alongside Matt Stryker. This past week, we witnessed chaos, anarchy, and bedlam, and clearly Superstars have no faith in Triple H.
And again, the WWE has been set on its ear, and the fallout will occur again this Monday on Raw. I can't wait to see what happens.
From Union City, New Jersey, AJ.
Right here. Go ahead, please.
Just going to comment on AJ.
Here is AJ. There she is, spry and spunky. But for me, I have to comment on what happened on Raw.
Sure.
This is the labor party, the workers' party, the proletariat, the working class walking out. And socialism, which is kind of what's going on in this country, sadly, is when the workers control the product. And that can't be the case. We need management, although you got to choose a side. Jack, where do you stand?
Oh, it's so hard for me to say. I mean, come on, I don't want to answer. There's a lot of questions I don't want to answer. That one is at the top of the list. You know, many superstars are asking a lot of questions. Everybody wants to know, how did Miz and R-Truth get past security at Hell in a Cell? Who raised the cage? Who lowered the cage? A lot of unanswered questions. And now I understand that Miz and R-Truth have actually filed a wrongful termination suit against Triple H.
Well, I think the biggest question is, Jack Corpella, who gave you your job? And how are you keeping it? How do you plan to stay employed? How do you plan to get a check every week?
That might be the best question I've ever heard.
Okay, so answer.
Who gave me my job?
Yeah.
It was an interview process through WWE, and now Triple H is in charge of that responsibility, and I plan on keeping it by doing the best job possible.
Okay. I mean, I got
Where are you going with this? I don't understand.
I got my class action notification in the mail yesterday, and I mean, look, I've got grievances too. I personally feel I'm a top-tier announcer, a top-tier manager. I could still go in the ring and put a mic in my hand, and again, I'm top-tier. Oh, but I've got to eat. So I'm sitting right here and trying to be as neutral as I possibly can. And I mean, despite the fact that my main grievance is I have to sit next to you every week, but
that I can deal
with.
I don't blame you for that, but let's not take away from two of the young and explosive divas here in the WWE. Wait till you hear how this match came to be.
Lay it on me, kid.
Tamina, who trains so hard, loves to lift weights, walked into the locker room after workout and found AJ preparing for a match by playing video games. Tamina was outraged. I talked to AJ. AJ said, hey, it puts me in the zone. It relaxes me. I like to play video games. Is there anything wrong with that?
This is no video game, of course, as Tamina has AJ locked up. How AJ is going to get out of this is beyond me. Look at the way Tamina's legs are straddling AJ. AJ has no choice but to try to slide out from there. You go.
You're going to get up.
Tamina, the daughter of WWE Hall of Famer Superfly Jimmy Snuka. Tamina was actually born in the United States, but Tamina said as a young girl, she was sent to Samoa because her ancestors believed she needed to learn how to be tough. Oh, and in Samoa, as an 8-year-old girl, Tamina would have to search through the jungle for food. Hold on, will this
really?
Do it? Yes, absolutely.
Wait a second. Superfly Jimmy Snuka, Hall of Famer, is from the island of Fiji,
yes.
Not from Samoa.
Right.
And you're going to tell me that Tamina had to go through the jungles looking for food?
Yes, coconuts.
Oh,
said that
my
she encountered
goodness.
Wild boars, on, snakes. Hey, ask Tamina.
No,
why would Tamina lie to me? That's the toughness is just
why would she lie? Maybe because some people would call you a rube, and she wanted to see if what she told you would make air. How gullible are you?
No, they've taken gullible out of the dictionary.
They've removed it, actually. Did you know that? In this edition of Webster's, gullible is not in the dictionary. Surprise?
Well, I know. Never mind. Back to the action. Oh! Now, AJ, certainly not the biggest diva in the WWE, but she makes up for it for speed and quickness. But right now, oh!
Making up for it right now is AJ needs to get some sort of offense going. AJ needs to get off of her back and use her athletic ability to try to neutralize Tamina's power.
Tamina, get off the road. Come on, Tamina, get off the road.
Tamina's having fun, though. That could be the break that AJ needs.
AJ has a reputation for being able to capitalize on the mistakes of other divas who may be bigger, who may be stronger. What a maneuver. Will this do it?
Wow.
Here is your winner, AJ.
Just like what's going on in Raw, it's going to take one little thing to change the momentum, and that little thing was an incredible maneuver from that little thing right there, AJ. Congratulations, AJ, a hard-fought victory.
The fearless and powerful Tamina appeared to be in control for much of this matchup, but credit AJ. Credit AJ for finding the opportunity she was waiting for. Look at this reversal. Look at the athleticism. Perhaps one of the advantages of the smaller size, the low body weight of AJ.
One more time, AJ able to rotate her hips, forces Tamina down on the back of her head, and thus AJ is victorious. Go ahead and smile, sweetie, you deserve it.
And still to come, Raw has been on the air for nearly 20 years, but this past week, we witnessed defiance and anarchy like we have never seen before.
Superstars walking out on Triple H. How will this affect Monday Night Raw this coming Monday? Boy, oh boy, the questions remain to be answered.
My name is Sheamus. I'm a WWE superstar, and I'm very excited to be representing the new Be A Star initiative. I'm here in the Hall neighborhood house in Connecticut, trying to educate everyone that being a bully isn't cool. Don't be a bully, be a star. Show tolerance and respect.
To have a star like Sheamus come here and tell the kids his own personal story that he had been bullied means something to these kids. Thanks to WWE and Sheamus for being here at Hall Neighborhood House right here in Bridgeport.
Getting a positive message out there, and most important thing is,
don't be a bully!
Be a star!
Welcome back to WWE Superstars, everybody. It's main event time.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Calgary, Alberta, Canada, weighing 195 pounds, Tyson Kidd.
A unique blend of high-flying ability complemented by excellent mat grappling that defines Tyson Kidd. DiBiase posse out in full effect here. Jack, I saw you talking to Ted DiBiase earlier today. Can you shed any insight into what's going through that competitor's mind?
Oh, now you're going to let me?
Well, why not? I know you do your research.
Well, this is legit. Ted DiBiase started something called the DiBiase posse, where before a show, he will actually go out and tailgate with the WWE Universe. Ted says he loves football, he loves hunting, he loves fishing, and he loves tailgating, and nothing gets Ted ready for a match like hanging out with the WWE Universe.
Well, Ted better love WWE more than all those things put together, because right now Ted DiBiase is in there with a technician in Tyson Kidd. You know, Jack, I just thought of something. With the walkout on Raw this Monday, will there be a Raw? Will we have scabs? Will the superstars be on strike? Maybe you could actually call Monday Night Raw. Michael Cole walked out. Booker T walked out. JR reluctantly walked out. Could be an opportunity for you, Jack.
Do you feel safe? Many superstars say that Triple H is negligent and they don't feel safe right now. Do you feel safe?
I do feel safe only because I was taught how to handle myself and I don't trust anybody.
Come on, you can't handle yourself if Miz and R-Truth come after you with a fight.
I'll take my chances.
Oh, wait a minute. Oh!
Wow. I think Triple H is in a tough spot. I mean, ask yourself at home, would you be able to run WWE?
Oh, my!
We should do a .com poll on WWE.com. Look at all the captains of industry. Where does Triple H rank?
And this, of course, our main event on WWE Superstars, a rematch from 2 weeks ago. Ted DiBiase won 2 weeks ago. I'm not so sure Ted's going to even be able to finish this match. Cover here. Look at this vicious kick to the head.
And this is what Triple H was talking about on Monday Night Raw. The WWE is a place where men fight. And Tyson Kidd embodies the WWE spirit with this type of aggression.
Tyson told me before this matchup, he needs to be more aggressive tonight. Tyson said, I don't care if I have to hurt myself to hurt Ted. I will win.
Watch your hair now. Watch your hair.
Speaking of aggression, tomorrow night on Friday Night SmackDown, weapon of mass destruction returns. The Big Show and Mark Henry is in the crosshairs.
That was Mark Henry who injured the Big Show, putting the Big Show out of action for several weeks. And Mark Henry said, when the Big Show returns, I will put the Big Show right back on the shelf.
But now, Mark Henry is the world's heavyweight champion.
Yes.
That almost adds sizzle to the steak.
Henry, a remorseless, seemingly unstoppable monster. Oh, it was such a huge win for, hold on, wait, Kid, no. Such a huge win for DiBiase 2 weeks ago. DiBiase told me it is so difficult being a third-generation superstar. People don't realize the shoes you have to fill when your dad is WWE Hall of Famer, the million-dollar man, Ted DiBiase, your grandfather's Iron Mike DiBiase. He said it's not easy. It takes time to find your own way. Certainly victories over Tyson Kidd would help Ted DiBiase's cause.
Come on, Teddy, huh? Come on, DiBiase. What do you got, huh? What do you got, huh? You got nothing.
There you go. That's what Teddy's got.
Now, why would Kid taunt DiBiase like that?
He had a moment of confidence.
Oh!
And it's only served to raise the ire of Ted DiBiase.
Oh! Whoa! What impact! DiBiase going for it all!
Yeah, but I question how much damage Tyson Kidd inflicted earlier because Ted DiBiase could have gotten a much deeper cover there.
Tyson Kidd, one of the hardest superstars to put away. Last superstar trained in the legendary Heart Dungeon. Possesses a never-say-quit attitude.
Whoa. A deep roll up there.
Will that do it? Here we go, Ted DiBiase.
This Heart Dungeon that you referred to is one of the most hallowed training grounds in WWE history.
Dream Street, he hit it! He hit Dream Street! Is it enough?
Here is your winner, Ted DiBiase!
A hard-fought victory that tells you perseverance and dedication will win out if you just stick to your guns. Congratulations, Ted DiBiase.
DiBiase is on a roll. Another hard-fought victory over Tyson Kidd. Dream Street. Nobody gets up from Dream Street.
One more look. Watch the impact. The way Tyson Kidd lands. Ted DiBiase well on his way to victory. And now, threat level red. Tomorrow night, a weapon of mass destruction is coming to explode on Friday Night SmackDown.
But still to come tonight, this past week, John Laurinaitis called for a vote of confidence in how Triple H is running things on Raw. We will show you the stunning and unprecedented fallout from this past week.
Superstars walking away, all in defiance of one man. Triple H now stands alone. What's the future of Monday Night Raw?
Rebound is brought to you by WWE Shop, the official WWE merchandise superstore.
I just want to assure all of you that I am in complete control of both Raw and SmackDown in the WWE.
Mr. Mr. COO.
I don't want the new you. The new you sucks. I want the old you.
You know that there's a conspiracy against me.
Once again, you're not going to do the right thing.
What kind of man are you?
You know, it seems to me that you don't quite get it, do you?
Triple H, you don't know how to run this company.
I think you're a poor excuse for COO.
I'm trying my ass off to be the man.
Triple H has lost total control.
Ms. Truth, you're fired.
Get him out of here!
Ms. and our Truth! They are assaulting Punk and Cena and the officials.
This is anarchy. The COO has exploded.
All we wanted was our jobs back. We have pressed assault charges on Triple H.
Triple H.
No one
has lost total control.
Is bigger than the WWE.
The Raw locker room is in uproar. I think you need to ask the talent for a vote of confidence. Or are you scared?
You want a vote of no confidence? You get everybody to that ring. I'll look them in the eye and I'll ask them. You just make sure you're there too.
This job, as I've said before, is a lot more difficult than I thought it would be. When it comes to running Monday Night Raw, I don't work for any of you. Every Monday night, I work my ass off for all of them. Now, I'm curious to hear your opinions.
Well, let's face it, Triple H, you're completely out of control.
All these years I've been an official, I've never seen this much abuse.
Triple H, I think this show is spiraling out of control. I don't think it's your fault. I think there's somebody behind the scenes trying to sabotage your job as COO. Only problem with that is everybody around this ring are paying the price for it. So like it or not, you're in charge and you're the reason all this is happening.
So on behalf of me and all of my colleagues, we vote no confidence.
I'm sorry, Triple H, no confidence.
Hunter, I'm sorry, no confidence.
I don't know if you hear what they're saying, but I'm saying no confidence too. I'm reluctantly walking out.